Who is SilLion Battery? Located in Broomfield, Colorado, and founded in 2014, they're a small startup with less than 10 employees and have been privately owned with a focus on lithium-ion battery tech and have been recently linked to Tesla. Don't let the smaller size fool you. They are an extension within the pre-existing lithium-ion ecosystem, meaning their technology has a much shorter path to commercialization than the next generation solid-state tech. They've been awarded 5 Small Business Innovation Research grants for about $2 million from the Navy, DOE, and the National Science Foundation. According to the abstract from a work documenting an award SilLion won in 2017, the broader impact and commercial potential of the Small Business Innovation Research project lied in prototyping and scaling a high-energy lithium-ion cell for commercialization that would directly enhance defense energy storage markets, such as aerial and underwater drones and global consumer device markets, while also proving the technology for further development in the global EV market. The aim was to provide 3 to 6 months of continuous drone flight time to create opportunities for the communication and defense industries, or providing batteries that take up half the space as the current generation. As we know, to date, and speaking in a general industry-wide sense, lithium-ion improvement has been slow, but the demand is now far higher than it's ever been. Specifically, this project proposed to enable a non-flammable, high-energy lithium-ion cylindrical cell with a silicon anode and nickel-rich cathode. Upon optimizing the prototype cell design, the anode was to be scaled for integration into cylindrical cells built for cycling and safety performance, in which iteration improvements would be made as necessary, and those cells were to be incorporated into a drone-ready pack design for delivery to an unnamed aerial vehicle manufacturing partner. Of course, with success proven in other markets, that paves the way for technology to be accepted in the wider-reaching EV market. The team at SilLion is beginning to rewrite the rulebook for lithium-ion battery design. Not only do the cathode and anode materials need to be next generation, the entire battery also needs revamping. They're shifting their focus to auxiliary battery materials, building a support system for the modern silicon and nickel-rich electrodes, using unique electrolyte compositions and electrode binders, while maintaining the advantage of decades of manufacturing expertise by premising their designs on compatibility with existing lithium-ion battery manufacturing methods. As Dr. Molina Piper explains, enabling the next-generation electrode materials will mean enabling a next-gen lithium-ion system design. Moreover, the strategy for attaining next-gen performance must be commercially viable. SilLion cell tech, through utilization of lower-cost materials and manufacturing compatibility, will be 30% less costly in terms of dollars per kilowatt-hour than the state-of-the-art lithium-ion cells. By approaching the problem from the view of the battery cell system, SilLion achieves its breakthrough energy density and performance. Over the past few years, lithium-ion battery design changes have only been achieving 5-6% energy density improvements each year. SilLion set out for a drastic break from the status quo in shifting away from the adherence to the same electrode materials that have been used for years. They're using a higher component of silicon material in the anode and a very high amount of nickel in the cathode. Silicon has roughly 10 times the capacity of graphite being used in battery anodes, but it also expands threefold during charging cycles. For comparison, most graphite anodes in commercialized batteries expand between 10 and 13%, while silicon expands roughly 300%. This, of course, can cause massive structural damage to the battery and compromises the solid electrolyte interface, or SEI, between the electrode and the liquid electrolyte. This phenomenon has limited widespread adoption of a few technologies, but SilLion has developed additives for the silicon anode, which function to preserve the battery cell's physical integrity. These chemical additives also improve the nickel cathode's thermal stability. They use a non-flammable liquid electrolyte in contrast to the flammable carbon electrolyte used in many lithium-ion batteries today. If you could use a refresher on batteries, check out the next episode titled Battery Investor Day Preparation that you'll see on the left at the end of this episode. The drawback of these modifications is that they require intricate and costly processing methods, making this approach less appealing in the manufacture of commercial batteries. As Dr. Evans of SilLion explains, quote, "Most of the published work around silicon anodes focuses on complex material modifications that ultimately will introduce manufacturing processes which are very difficult to scale," end quote. A simple, scalable solution to the silicon anode is one key to higher performing batteries. By improving the anode's performance, you can increase a battery's maximum energy output by 20 to 30%. However, in order to unlock the true potential of the battery, the cathode needs to be similarly enhanced. In terms of the cost of producing lithium-ion batteries, the cathode accounts for roughly 30% of the total expense on average, more than twice that of the anode. Most conventional lithium-ion batteries use expensive and toxic cathodes containing large amounts of cobalt, limiting their widespread application to electric vehicles. SilLion's first generation pouch format cells are supposed to be 350 watt-hours per kilogram. Most commercially available lithium-ion batteries are well below 285 watt-hours per kilogram. They do also have a generation of cylindrical cells that are in the process of being tested to scale to become commercially available. Their business model is essentially to license the cell designs and tech to the existing markets because of the ease of which it would transfer to existing manufacturing lines. This way, they wouldn't have to build or own costly and expensive manufacturing operations. As a point of reference, most in the EV industry believe lithium-ion batteries will need gravimetric energy densities of over 350 watt-hours per kilogram in order to begin gaining mass market adoption. Of course, there are plenty of other factors that go into this, but that has served as somewhat of a benchmark for some time. Of course, many OEMs will ultimately want next-gen tech like solid-state batteries, but lithium-ion batteries will remain essential for decades to come. SilLion could allow the transportation industry to jump to a higher performance energy density with less thermal issues, leading to increased safety and lower costs. They should be able to do this without disrupting the existing supply chain, equipment, or processes that are in place today. SilLion has shown that when integrated into their unique system, state-of-the-art nickel-rich cathodes and silicon anodes demonstrate a much improved structural stability and safety, even at high temperatures. Dr. Melina Piper also says that SilLion has created the first viable, 80% by weight, silicon lithium-ion battery anode capable of integration into standard electrode manufacturing processes. They have worked with over 24 types of silicon active materials, all showing marked improvement in capacity retention and coulombic efficiency when used in SilLion's anode systems, regardless of the size or shape of silicon particles. This ability to turn so many commercially available silicon materials into effective anodes could send shockwaves through the industry, making the current over-engineered silicon anodes look overpriced by comparison. Around 2 years ago, Ed Williams, the CEO of the Colorado Clean Tech Industries Association, said the SilLion tech had the potential to be rolled out within 24 months, subject to refined engineering for charging rates and improved cold temperature performance. This quote was just over 24 months ago, as of April 2020. Williams also said that aviation and defense were initial target markets, but the demand was very high for the tech and they were in talks with many industries. Of course, many in the Tesla community have speculated that Tesla may have recently acquired a lithium-ion battery startup in Colorado, as Tesla was looking for a cell technician in Louisville, Colorado. But that job posting has since been removed. Additionally, employees of SilLion, Simon Hafner, Daniela Molina Piper, and Tyler Evans, the co-founders, have expressed interest in Tesla or added Tesla to their job experience outright. SilLion has also taken down their official website, which has in some historical instances been a sign of takeover or acquisition. The exact details of SilLion's battery design remain confidential, but the problematic expansion effects that plague modern silicon anodes appear to have been overcome. As Dr. Evans stated, the anodes display a minimal decrease in capacity after hundreds of charging and discharging cycles and exhibit high coulombic efficiencies, meaning that the charge is reversibly and effectively transferred through the system. This efficiency has been tested and proven with a variety of electrolyte materials, including the coveted non-flammable electrolytes, which also shows the flexibility of the SilLion system. Ultimately, through development projects already underway and in the pipeline, SilLion is targeting a battery prototype that is predicted to deliver roughly 390 watt-hours per kilogram, far greater than any commercial lithium-ion battery currently available. And finally, the time has come to give away this light-up Tesla sign. I apologize for the delay in getting to this, no excuses here. That being said, here's the list of all the names that we entered into the drawing. Take a moment to pause and look for your name if you'd like to now. Up next will be the drawing that we recorded live. Alright guys, here's how this will work. We're gonna roll two virtual dice. Once it lands on a number adding up to more than four, we will randomize this list with all of the entrants that number of times, and whoever lands in the number one slot on that number will win. Best of luck. 4 plus 3 is 7. So we're gonna randomize this list 7 times. I did add a few of you in there multiple times just to say thank you to our Patreon supporters. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the winner is whoever lands in the number one slot right here. James Leonard Paynes. Congratulations, my friend. Thank you for entering. Go ahead and reach out to me in this YouTube video or on Instagram or shoot me an email and I'll go ahead and get this sign out to you. Just in case James doesn't see this, doesn't reach out to me, I will do this again exactly 1 week from now if I don't hear from James. Thanks, guys.